train station will be packed. There will be masses of people passing through. The shop owners will open up their storefronts. The florist will arrange his flowers. The ticket office will hum with inquiries. The porter will carry luggage. There will be tourists and workers and shoppers. But for now, there's only me.
And us.
Yeah.
And my coat. And this bench. And the air is cool. And the asphalt is gray. And as the light passes through the east windows in the great hall picking up the dust, the shadows of night start to fade. This is Emily. She's always here the earliest. She works in the cafe and wears a red dress. She sets out the tables and chairs before people arrive. She works hard. She doesn't always know what for. She had a boyfriend. But not anymore. It was summer. But by the fall, she was alone. The man from the lost property office smiles at Emily, but never says hello. He walks past the ticket office in the main hall as the trains are starting to arrive and leave, and the day is underway.
And all I see is war, 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 and people running away from war. Also, I'm trying to quit smoking. It's quite difficult.
On a Friday, Emily's first customers are these two old ladies who come into the cafe. They both smoke all the time. They sit in the seats closest to the fountain and share a cup of tea. They wear lipstick that matches the color of their shoes. She wanted to be an ice skater, but one of her feet was too big. And the other one played the piano until her fingers stopped working so well. Emily empties their ashtrays and asks them how they are.
Odgasa tampala, odgasa.
Trina,
papa, papa.
waiting for her brother. She hasn't seen him since he joined the army 4 years ago. He wrote her a letter arranging a time and a date. And she bought a new dress. And the trains go. Lunchtime comes, and lunchtime goes.
These two are always fighting. He raises his voice. And sometimes she cries. And they both say things they don't mean. In the end, he always says he's sorry. Emily finishes her cigarette, dusts off her apron, and goes back to work. These two are running away together. He's bought them two tickets for the 3:15 train.
Tonight, on their first night in a new city, they will spend half of their savings on a hotel room, where he will propose. And of course, she'll say yes. And together they'll dream of having a baby girl with big brown eyes, who they'd love very much. But it just didn't happen. And the two of them would grow old together in a whitewashed house where he would grow tomatoes.
I think in this country they say tomatoes. Not tomatoes.
This is the man from the Lost Property Office. People bring him things that get left behind at the station or on trains. He puts them in boxes and lines them up in a row. He doesn't need a ladder, because he's so tall. You wouldn't believe all the things that he finds. Like a cactus. And books. And keys. Or false teeth. She would take him out into the back garden and teach him the names of all the different types of flowers. He could identify all different types just from their smell. Sam is colorblind, though his customers would never know it. One day a bell rang as the door to the shop opened, and a woman walked in. She smelled of rain. She knocked a vase from the ledge. Sam helped her to pick up the pieces One day, they too would be married. And they'd have six children, named Iris, Lily, Rose, Lavender, Petal.
And a boy!
His name was Pussy Willow.
Vaz, not Basie.
Wait! Let's do something else. This woman is still waiting for her brother. She's been waiting all day. Maybe he got lost. I don't know. And as the last of the commuters make their way home, dozing on the trains, Emily wipes down the last of the tables and turns the sign around so it says closed. She dreams of one day having a party where she might light some candles, lay out some tablecloths, maybe even push the tables aside and dance through the night.
Up down the streets in the cold rain, outside as warm as a bed with a maid, and I find it's all the waves and rays that makes the days go on this way.
The tide goes in, and the tide goes out. And love? Love is everywhere. It's just that sometimes, you have to look pretty hard for it.
Mm-hmm. You're right. Sorry, excuse me, just a second.
sentimental. It was serious, but it was sentimental.
Yeah, we worked really hard on this show. I think it's supposed to be both.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm just helping them out.
A little bit serious.
Serious and sentimental.
A lot sentimental. Right? It makes the contrast.
Well, you know, it was just a clarification.
Please,
yeah, it's fine. It's really, they're fine with it.
Yeah,
look, they're okay.
I get it. It's just
hard. Yeah, I needed to